गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रन सो लेट्स ओके नो डाउन दिस क्वेश्चंस दैट दे के दैट टेस्ट पेपर फर्स्ट लेट अस डू द करेक्शन एंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स वी कैन स्टार्ट विद आवर रेगुलर पोर्शन ओके नो डाउन द क्वेश्चंस थिंक So the questions were like this, isn't it? First part, what is the value of p of n comma n minus 1? Okay, the question first one is value of p of n comma n minus 1. The options given were first one is n. Second one, it is 2n. Third one, it is n factorial. And fourth one, none of these. How to do this? What is this? P of n comma n minus 1 means it is npn, isn't it? This npn minus 1. What is npn minus 1? What is the definition of npr? Definition of npr is n factorial by n minus r factorial. So here npn minus 1 means it is n factorial by n minus of this 1. So you get plus n minus 1 will get cancelled. So we will get n factorial. N factorial is the answer. Okay. Second one. Second question. Is it over, children? Huh? Shall I do the next one? Next one is, in how many ways, write the question, in how many ways can 8 students be seated in a line? In how many ways can 8 students be seated in a line? And the options were 40230, second option, third one 5040. And the fourth option is 50400. In how many ways 8 students can be seated? What is the answer? 8 students in, okay, in one line means 8 places are there. So it is same as, will it be same as 8 factorial? And what is 8 factorial? What is 8 factorial? It is 5 factorial into 6 into 7 into 8. 5 factorial is 120 into 42 into 8. Simplify and calculate the answer, children. What is your answer? Check your answer. Shabari, what is the answer for this one?
40320.
Okay. Is it okay, children? Is it okay? The next one, how many three letter words with or without meaning can be formed out of the letters? How many three letter words can be formed out with or without meaning using the letters of the word logarithms? Logarithms, if the repetition of the letter is not allowed. If the repetition is not allowed. So if the repetition is not allowed means we can use the permutation formula, isn't it? So look at their algorithms, logarithms. Is there any letter repeating there? L is not repeating. O, G, logarithms is the word used. Logarithms. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Is it a 10 letter word? Is it logarithms or logarithm? Logarithms. Is it a 10 letter word? So it will be from 10 letters. If you are arranging 3 letters, means it will be 10P3, isn't it? And what is 10P3? 10 onwards, you'll write 3 numbers, 10 into 9 into 8. So what is the answer? Is it 720? Is it correct, children? Is it? Yes.
We should have divided by 1 into 2 into 3.
It is for combination. That is for combination.
Okay.
Permutation, there is no division. So it will be 720. Now look at the next case, fourth question. Look at the next one, fourth one. The number that can be formed. Okay. Fourth question is, write the question. The number of all the numbers, the number of all numbers that can be formed by using the number of all numbers that can be formed by using sum, S-O-M-E, sum. The number of all numbers that can be formed by using sum or all the digits, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, without repetition is dash. So the question is, how many numbers formed? Okay, it is not given, is it a one digit number? You can use all these digits. Using all these digits, how many numbers can be formed? So we can form one digit number, isn't it? So one digit number means total there are 5 without no repetition. So it is 5P1, isn't it? How many numbers can be formed? How many one digit numbers can be formed? It is 5P1. What is 5P1? It is 5. Second case, two-digit number. So it will be 5P2. So 5 into 4. Then same way, three-digit number. Three-digit numbers will be 5P3, which will be 5 into 4 into 3. Then four-digit number, 5P4. So which is 5 into 4 into 3 into 2. Suppose we use all the digits, means 5 digit number. How many 5 digit numbers can be made? So it will be 5P5, which is 5 factorial 120. Okay, 120. Here also it is 120. Here it is 5, it is 20, it is 60. So how many numbers? All the cases we can add. So when you add up, what is the total? 120 plus 120, 240 plus 85. So answer will be 325. Is it okay? Is it clear, children? Now look at the next one. Is it okay? Now look at the next one. A lady wants to select, write this question, next one. A lady wants to select one cotton sari and one polyester sari from a textile shop. Let's say a lady wants to select one cotton sari and one polyester sari from a textile shop. A lady wants to select one cotton sari and one polyester sari from a textile shop. If there are 15 cotton and 13 polyester varieties, if there are 15 cotton and 13 polyester varieties in that shop, if there are 15 cotton and 13 polyester varieties in that shop, in how many ways can she pick up 2 saris? In that shop, how many ways can she pick up 2 saris? What is the answer? Okay, there are 15 cotton saris. From the 15 cotton, she wants to select one sari. So Similarly, polyester sarees, there are 13 polyester sarees and she wants to select one saree. And she wants one from polyester and one from cotton. Two, okay, total she wants two sarees. What is the answer? From each one we want to select. So it is 15C1 into, is it 12 or 13? How many polyester sarees are there? 12, 13. So it is 15C1 into 13C1. It is 15C1 into 13C1. What is the answer? 15C1 into 13C1 is the answer. Okay. So 15 into 13, you'll get the answer. Okay. Go through these questions again. Okay. So when you prepare it, when you prepare for the test paper, you learn the definition, understand it and do it. Okay. Okay, children, shall we start with our sequences and series? In the last class, we are discussing problems from sequences and series. Shall we start?
Yes.
So we discussed about arithmetic mean, isn't it? Arithmetic mean of two numbers, A and B, is given by John Philip. Arithmetic mean of two numbers, A and B, is given by arithmetic mean of two numbers A and B is given by A plus B by 2, isn't it? Malavika, arithmetic mean of A and B is given by?
A plus B by 2.
A plus B by 2, okay? So suppose we are given two numbers, we can insert so many arithmetic means between the numbers so that the resulting sequence will be an AP. The resulting sequence will be an AP. Okay, so now write these questions, right? If sum of n terms of an AP, is 3n square plus n. If sum of n terms of an AP is 3n square plus 5n, comma, mth term is 164. Mth term is 164. Find m. Find m. The sum of n terms of an AP is 3n square plus 5n. The sum of n terms of an AP is 3n square plus 5n. And mth term is 164. Mth term is 164. You have to find m. How will you do this? SN is given. We want to find AM. AM means A plus N minus 1 D. We want to find M. We don't know what is A. We don't know what is D. Is it possible to calculate A and D? How will you calculate A and D? SN is given. What we know about SN? SN means? SN is sum to? N terms, sum to N terms. So S1 will be same as S1, A1. Okay, so we get A. What will be S2? S2 is sum of first two terms, isn't it? So S2 means we'll get A1 plus A2. So and substituting A1, we will find out the second term. So now first term we have, second term we have, if we subtract, we will get the common difference. Then substitute it in AM and you can find what is M. Okay. Okay. Listen, children. Listen. SN is given. SN means sum to N terms. So we start with S1. What is S1? S1 will be same as A1. So it is 3 into 1 square plus 5 into 1. So it will be 3 into 1 square. It is 3 plus 5, which is 8. So we get A1 as 8. Find out S2. What will be S2? S2 is A1 plus A2. S2 will be same as A1 plus A2. So which is equivalent to, in the place of N, you substitute 2. 3 into 2 square plus 5 into 2. So 3 into 2 square. 2 square means 4. 4 into 3 is 12. 12 plus 10, which is 22. So we get A1 plus A2 is 22. A1 Already it is 8. So 8 plus a2 is 22. Therefore, what is a2? 22 minus 8. So therefore, what is a2? 22 minus 8. Is it 14? Yes, children, what happened? Yes, Aditya?
27.
M is 27. Is it correct, Shabrinath? Yes. M is 27. Now write the next one. Insert five numbers. Insert five numbers between 8 and 26. Insert five numbers between 8 and 26. Insert five numbers between 8 and 26 such that the resulting sequence is an AP. Such that the resulting sequence is an AP. Insert five numbers between 8 and 26. Okay, this is an important one mark question. Insert five numbers between 8 and 26 such that the resulting sequence is an AP. So between 8 and 26, we are going to insert five numbers. Between 8 and 26, we are going to insert five numbers. A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, 8 and 26. So when we insert five numbers between 8 and 26, what is the total number of terms? Total number of terms will become
seven,
isn't it? When we insert five terms between, already two terms are there. So 5 plus 2, total number of terms will become 7. Jewel, can you give the first term of the sequence? What is the first term here? 8. A is 8. And the seventh term, isn't it? A7 is 26. A7 means it is A plus 6D is 26. A we know, A is 8. A plus 6D is 26. From here, what is 6D? 26 minus 8. So it is 18, isn't it? Therefore, we get the common difference as 3. If the common difference is 3, you can write down what is A1. A2, A3, A4, A5, A6. What are the numbers we insert? It is an AP. When we insert these numbers, it will be an AP, isn't it? If the common number, common difference is given, we can find the remaining terms. Navaneet, can you give what is A1, A2 and all? Navaneet?
Yes, ma'am. A1, 8 plus...
3, common difference.
3. 2 minus 1 into 3.
Why?
Second term.
So 8 plus 3, A1 is 11, isn't it? So what will be A2? You add the common difference. See? Okay, it is an AP. This is an AP. So first term we got as 8. It is given. Now we know that common difference is 3. So if you add this 3, we will get the successive terms. So it will be A2?
14.
A3?
17.
20. Next is 20.
23.
23.
26.
A6 is already there, 26. Is it okay? Is it clear? Navaneet, is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
What about the others? Is it okay, children? Inserting the numbers. When we insert some few arithmetic means between the given numbers, we'll be getting that as an AP. It is an arithmetic progression. Okay. Now the next one. Next one is a very, very important question. Try now. If okay, these questions are from your textbook, NCERT textbook questions only we are doing now. Okay. If a raised to n plus b raised to n by a raised to n minus 1 plus b raised to n minus 1. Is the AM, between A and B? What is this AM?
Arithmetic mean.
Arithmetic mean. If this is AM between A and B, find the value of N. Find the value of N. If A raised to N plus B raised to N by A raised to N minus 1, plus b raised to n minus 1 is the AM between A and B. Find the value of n. How to do this? To find the value of n. Okay, so now listen. Listen, children, it is given a raised to n plus b raised to n by a raised to n minus 1 plus b raised to n plus n minus 1 is the arithmetic mean. It is the arithmetic mean of a and b. So arithmetic mean means what we know. How will you find the arithmetic mean? Add both the numbers and divide by 2. A plus B by 2 is A raised to N plus B raised to N by A raised to N minus 1 plus B raised to N minus 1. It is the arithmetic mean of A and B. Next step, we cross multiply these two. Cross multiply. So when we cross multiply, A plus B into, listen children, don't write. First listen all of you. Is equal to 2 into a raised to n into b raised to n. It's an important question. Listen, all of you. I'll give time for copying. First, listen. So now open the bracket. Distributivity. When you open the bracket, if you take a and when you multiply this, we'll get a raised to n. Plus, if you take a and multiply with the next term, we will get a b raised to n minus 1. Again, if you open this one, if you multiply this, b a raised to n minus 1 plus b raised to n is equal to 2a raised to n plus 2b raised to n. You just open the brackets. Now, plus a n, if you take to other side, what you will get? It will become minus a n, isn't it? So you get a b raised to n minus 1 plus b a raised to n minus 1 is 2 a raised to n minus a raised to n. Positive a raised to n on taking other side, it will become minus. Similarly, plus 2 b raised to n is here. You take negative b raised to n to other side. So from 2 a raised to n, 1 a raised to n is removed, means you'll get a raised to n plus b raised to n is a b raised to n minus 1 plus b a raised to n minus 1. Now listen, look at the next point. Next step, we group the terms with powers of a to one side and powers of b to another side. Up to this point, is it okay? Okay, up to this, is it okay? After that, we can discuss the remaining points. Up to this, is it okay? It is given as the arithmetic mean. It is given as the arithmetic mean of A and B. So we equate that number is equal to A plus B by 2. Next step, we cross multiply, we expand. Okay, we use distributivity, expand it, and we bring the terms to one side and we simplify. Up to that, is it okay? Go through it and check, is it okay? John Philip, is it okay?
A into A raised to n minus 1. How is that A raised to n?
Okay, we have one property. What is A raised to m into A raised to n? It is A raised to m plus n, isn't it? When we multiply, add the powers. So here, A raised to n minus 1 into A means it is A raised to 1. That is same as A raised to n minus 1 plus 1. So it will be A raised to n. Okay?
Thank you. Yes, ma'am.
Is it okay, children? Any other doubt? Shall I move? Shall I proceed?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now look at the next. Listen, children. Look at the next step. You bring the powers of A to one side and the powers of B to other side. How we are rearranging? We just rearrange. When we rearrange, you take all the terms with powers of A. So here is power of A. So you bring A raised to N to one side equal to B raised to N. Powers of B. Now look at these two terms. From these two terms, which one you can take as common? From these two terms, A raised B, A raised to N minus 1, A raised to N. So which one we can take as common? Smaller power we can take as common. Is that no? Suppose we have like this, B x square minus x cube. Which one you can take as common? From these two terms, the smaller power, the smaller exponent we can take. So we will be getting B minus X. Same way here, A raised to N minus 1 is the smaller power. So we'll get B minus A equal to, from these two terms we can take B raised to N minus 1 as common. So we'll get B minus A. Okay, so now B minus A, both the sides we can cancel. So we get A raised to N minus 1 is B raised to N minus 1. So listen, look at the next step. Okay, suppose we are having like this. A is equal to B. Shall I write A by B is 1? Is it possible?
Yes.
A is equal to B. That means, is it same as writing A by B is 1? Okay, so that is the method you use here. So we use A N minus 1 by B N minus 1 is 1. So that is same as A by B whole raised to N minus 1 is 1, which is same as A by B raised to 0. How? How?
Something raised to 0 is 1.
Very good. Anything raised to 0 is 1. Here we have 1. If you look in LHS, it is in the form of A by B raised to. So RHS also, we are expressing RHS, we have 1. RHS also, we are expressing in terms of A by B. We can write it as A by B raised to 0. Anything raised to 0 is 1. So we express that as A by B raised to 0. Now look at here, the base are same. Values are same. Okay, so sometimes we used to, we solve like this, x square is equal to 5 square. Therefore, what we say, x is 5, isn't it? Values are same and the exponents are same means base must be same, powers must be same. The same way here, bases are equal, values are equal. That means n minus 1 is 0. Therefore, what is the value of n? N is 1. What we have to find here? What do you have to find? After doing all these things, you are not remembering, isn't it? Look at the question. What is asked? What do you have to find? Find n. Our aim is to find n. Okay. Here the question is given A raised to n plus 1, A raised to n by B raised to n by A raised to n minus 1 plus B raised to n minus 1 is the arithmetic mean of A and B. It is arithmetic mean means A plus B by 2. Cross multiply, do it. Okay. Do the same question as today's homework. It's an important question. Mark it as important in your textbook, in your notebook, and do it the same question as homework. Similar question is there in geometric mean. After completing a arithmetic mean, we'll be doing that one also. Finished? Is it over?
No.
Shall we do the next one? Okay, write the next one. Write the next one, children. Write the question. Between 1 and 31, this is again an important question. Mark it as important. Between 1 and 31, m numbers have been inserted. Between 1 and 31, m numbers have been inserted. Between 1 and 31, m numbers have been inserted. In such a way that, the resulting sequence is an AP. In such a way that the resulting sequence is an AP. And the ratio of seventh and m minus one numbers is 5:9. Ratio of 7th and m minus 1th numbers is 5:9. seventh and m minus oneth numbers is 5:9. Find the value of m. Find the value of m. So between 1 and 31, m numbers have been inserted. Between 1 and 31, m numbers have been inserted in such a way that the resulting sequence is an AP, and the ratio of seventh and m minus oneth numbers is 5:9. Find the value of m. Listen, children, look at this. Read the question before. Okay, here what is given? When you look, read this, between 1 and 31, we insert m numbers. Okay, we insert m numbers. So how many terms are there in the sequence? Between 1 and 31, we insert m numbers such a way that the resulting sequence is an AP. So how many terms will be there in the sequence when we insert m number? Yes, Aditya. Yes, repeat it. M plus 2. Is it clear, children? Okay, if you get the concept, you can understand it easily. Between 1 and 31, we insert m numbers. We insert m numbers. So we will be getting the resultant will be a sequence. It is a sequence with m plus 2 terms. It is a sequence. After inserting this, we get a sequence. Okay. Now answer my question. The first number will be same as dash of the sequence. I'm inserting m numbers. We insert m numbers between 1 and 31 so that we get a sequence with m plus 2 terms. Now my question is, the first number will be same as dash of the sequence. What happens? You're inserting the first number in the sequence. So the first number of the sequence will be same as dash of the sequence. Yes. Okay. Suppose we insert the numbers. Suppose I insert the numbers x1, x2, etc. up to xm. Okay. I'm inserting m numbers. So here x1 is the first number. But if you look into the sequence, x1 is the
second term.
Okay. The first number will become the second term of the sequence. Is it correct? Similarly, the second number will be the third term of the sequence. So fifth number will be the
sixth term.
So mth number, look at here it is given, mth number. So mth number will be m plus 1th term. That is the point you have to note here. Okay. So when we insert these numbers, it is an AP. So 1 with that numbers inserted is an AP. It is an AP with m plus 2 terms. Okay. So in this AP, first term is 1 and AM plus 2th term is 31. Is it correct? AM plus 2 is 31. Okay. If we continue also, I hope you'll not be able to complete. You try to solve it. Okay. Find out and come. Next class we can discuss it. Okay. One. Answer your attendance, children. Okay. You'll not be able to complete that. So anyhow, try it. With this clues, you try to solve it. Thank you, children. Thank you. Okay.
Did you call my name?
Yes, Atulya.
Did you find me?
Yes, yes. I have marked your attendance. Okay. Thank you.